Hello everyone, I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. In this video, I want to show you how to install and how to configure an access point so to boost the Wi-Fi signal in your house. In my video, I'll be using this access point from UEV. I'm gonna be showing you how to configure it and how to connect it in both the access point mode and the repeater mode. And I'm gonna be performing also an internet speed test to see if this access point will hinder the internet speed in case you connect to it. So let me start first by showing you what comes in the box with this access point. So this is everything that comes with the access point. You have the access point, you have a power adapter, you have some screws in case you want to install it on the wall or on the ceiling, you have an Ethernet cable, and you have the manual. So these are the ports of the access point. You have the first one here, which is the DC in case you want to power the access point using an external adapter. Then you have an Ethernet port here, and this is at the same time power over Ethernet and WAN. The other one is if you want to connect a device directly to the access point. And the last one is a reset button in case you want to reset your access point. And I wanted to show you also on the back of this access point, if you want to install it on the wall or on the ceiling, you have this back plate here. You can simply push it up and remove it. So you can install it on the wall, and then you can install the access point like this. The first connection mode I'm gonna show you is the access point mode. So let me show you how to connect it in access point mode. You need the power adapter, you need the Ethernet cable that came with it, and you need another Ethernet cable. First, connect the power adapter to the power outlet, and then connect one end of the Ethernet cable to the PoE port here on the power adapter. And the other end, you need to connect it to the PoE port here on the access point. So this powers the access point. You see it is powering up now. Now, to give it internet access, this is what you need to do. This is the other Ethernet cable. You need to put it in the LAN port in the power adapter here. And the other end of the Ethernet cable should go in any LAN port of your router. So now wait for the access point to boot up. So now the access point booted up and you see the LED light is blue. Now I'm gonna switch to a screen recording to show you how to configure it. So this here is my Windows 11 PC. So to configure the access point, you need first to connect to its default SSID. So click on the network icon here. And then click next to the Wi-Fi networks here. And here you need to find the default access point. It starts with UEV. So here you have UEV 2.4 GHz and UEV 5.8 GHz. I'm gonna connect to the 5 GHz. You can choose either one. And then click on connect. And here you have the default password is 8x6. And then click on next. So now it is connected and it's normal that you don't have internet now. So now we need to change the IP of the PC so we can connect to the access point to configure it. So right click on the network icon here. And then choose network and internet settings. So click on Wi-Fi. And then here click on the internet connection that you have. And here we need to change the IP assignment. So click edit here next to the IP assignment. And change automatic to manual. And then enable IPv4. And enter IP address, put the following: 192.168.188.5. And for the subnet mask, put 255.255.255.0. And then click on save. And then let me minimize this. And now open your web browser and go to this address, 192.168.188.253, and hit enter. So this is the administration page of the access point. The default password is admin. Of course, change it afterwards. So now this is admin, and then click on login. We need to click on wizard. So here, click on the access point mode. And for the connection, keep it by default get IP from AC, and then click next. So this is a 2.4 gigahertz band here. And here, this is the SSID that you're gonna give to the access point mode in 2.4 gigahertz band. And here I'm gonna take a moment to talk about the SSID because this is a question that I get all the time. So I get the question that Can we use the same SSID that is on our router on our access point so that the devices can roam between the two like devices, the router and the access point? The short answer is yes, but there are many drawbacks to this. The first drawback is that you will not know to what device you are connecting in case you want to manage the device. And the second drawback is that some of the devices will not work if you have two devices broadcasting the same SSID. To give you an example, my Google Home Mini like was lost when I put the same SSID and it wasn't connecting anymore to any of the SSIDs. So here it's better to choose another SSID. So here I'm gonna remove everything after 2.4. So I'm gonna keep it like this, UEV 2.4. And for the wireless mode, I'm gonna keep it by default, channel also by default, encryption also by default. And for the password, let's change it to something that is really simple. So my pass 069. So let's click on next here. And here you need to configure the 5 GHz band. So I'm gonna do the same. And what is good about this access point is that it also covers the 160 MHz band, but I'm not gonna use it now. So I'm gonna keep it on the 80. And the password, let's also put the password my pass 069. And for the time reboot, I'm gonna keep it by default. So let's click on next here. And now the access point is configured and it is restarting. It takes about 2-3 minutes to restart. So now the device restarted. Let's connect to the newly created SSIDs. So click on the network icon here. And then let's click next to network here, Wi-Fi. So here you have the two SSIDs that we created. I'm gonna connect to the 5 GHz band. So let me put the password, my pass 069. So it is connected and we have access to the internet. And we don't need to remove the manual IP because this manual IP is tied to the old SSID, which is the default SSID. Whereas this new SSID created a new connection and this new connection got an automatic IP assignment with DHCP. So here, let's click on the plus sign to show you that we have internet connection. So let's go to Netflix internet speed test. And you see that it is working. And here I have an internet connection speed of 120 megabits download and it is working fine. So it is giving me even more than 120 megabits. So this is a normal speed that I get usually. And the access point is not hindering the speed of my internet connection. So now I'm gonna show you how to configure the device in repeater mode. To configure the device in repeater mode, you need to disconnect it from your router. So I'm gonna disconnect it by removing this Ethernet cable from the power adapter. And now I'm gonna reset it so that to configure it from the beginning. So this is a reset button here. I'm gonna press and hold it for 5 seconds. And now it is resetting. See how the LED light is blinking. So now that the device resetted, we need to reconnect to the default SSID and we need to rechange our IP address. So I'm gonna do this quickly. I'm gonna connect first to the default SSID of the device. So remember it is UEV 2.4 or 5. I'm gonna connect to the 5 GHz one. I'm gonna remove the connect automatically, click on connect. And the password is 8x6. And let's click on next. So now let's change the IP. We can change it from here if you click on the I here. And then you can go here to IP assignment, edit, manual. And let's put it 192.168.188.10. And let's put the subnet mask 255.255.255.0. So now we can access the device to configure it. So let's open our browser and let's go to 192.168.188.253. So this is the default IP of the device. So here, let's put the default password and I'm gonna take this chance here to show you how to change the default password. So it is admin, login, and here to change the default password, you see this one here, hover over it and then click here. And here you can change the default password. I'm not gonna do it now. So now let's configure our device in repeater mode. Click on the wizard, click on repeater mode here. And here the first option, you have by default 2.4 GHz band, and this is a backbone connection from the device to the router. It's better to use the 5 GHz band.
So I'm gonna click here on the box, and then I'm gonna choose use 5 gig, and here I'm gonna click on scan. So the device now search for all the Wi-Fi networks that are transmitting on the 5 GHz band, and here's a list. My network is called Asus 5G. I'm gonna select it, and here I'm gonna leave the wireless mode by default. The encrypt, I'm gonna click on the box here, and I'm gonna choose WPA, WPA2, because this is the encryption on my router. And here I'm gonna put the password to allow this device to connect to the router on this SSID. So the password is mypass069, and I'm gonna click on next. And here it's asking us to configure the repeated network, the 2.4 gigahertz one. So here I'm gonna remove everything after 2, and then I'm gonna put RP for repeated, and for the encryption I'm gonna keep it the same, but for the password I'm gonna put mypass071. So let's click on next now. And this is here the same, but for the 5 gigahertz repeated network. So I'm gonna remove everything after 5 once again, and I'm gonna put RP for repeated, and for the password I'm gonna put also the same password. So next, and here for the connection, it's not static IP. I'm gonna be connecting to my router with the dynamic IP. So here I'm gonna click on the drop down list. I'm gonna choose get IP from gateway. And in this case, the gateway is our router. So click on next and click on OK. And now the device will reboot. And then I'm gonna show you how to connect to the repeated network, and we're gonna do an internet speed test. So here the access point rebooted. Let me minimize this and let's connect to the newly created SSIDs. And let's search for UEV5RP. So this is the 2 and this is the 5. Let's connect to the 5 GHz band. Connect, and this is the new password, mypass071. Let's click on next. And you notice here that we connected, but we don't have internet access. And this is a bug in Windows 11. To correct this, this is what you need to do if you face this problem. Go to control panel. So click on the search box and then type in control, and you have control panel. Open it. And here go to network and sharing center. And here click on change adapter settings. And you see this is a Wi-Fi adapter. So let's see what IP it has. Right click on it, click properties. And then here you have IPv4, double click on it. And you see it has still the manual IP assignment, but it is empty. So let's click on obtain an IP address automatically. Let's click OK. And you're gonna see how now when I click OK, it takes a couple of seconds and then we'll have an internet connection. So let's click OK. Let's wait for it. And you see how now we have an internet connection. So let's go back to Microsoft Edge. And let me open a new tab and go to fast. And you're gonna notice that the speed will not reach the maximum speed, so it is not as fast as the AP mode. But the convenience of the repeater mode is that you can configure it without a physical Ethernet cable. And this is the speed here, so it is 110, so we lost a bit of the speed. If you wanna check out this access point from UEV, I'm gonna leave an Amazon affiliate link in the description below. If you make a purchase using my link, I will gain a small percentage at no cost to you, and this will help my channel greatly. I want to thank you all for watching, and if you like this video and you found it useful, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give it a thumbs up. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.